Alright, today we're on a bit of a different trip. We're going on a boat, not the bloody van. So I'm going on a bit of an adventure with young Dan here.
And
we'll get out underway and we'll have a sit down, have a chat with Dan a bit later on about what he's doing over here. But in the meantime, we're heading to an island. Enjoy. Oh, what happened, mate?
I slipped on the boat.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Cowboys don't cry, they just sing sad songs.
You'll be right.
Oh, no. Yep. So this won't be where they end up?
No. No, we'll move them. But that's not till the tide goes out.
Oh, okay.
So yeah.
Another adventure.
Another adventure.
Awesome. So Ruapuke Island is whānau owned. It's been handed down in the generations, you know, through
three prominent families, that being the topis, the key owls, and the white trees. But there's also a whole heap of other people that affiliate to the island. Ruapuke has never signed over in the treaty at all, so part of Tuaiuki's agreement to sign the treaty was that Ruapuke was left for the people of the island, which is, you know, that's why we're so fortunate today. So all these islands, so you've got Bird Island behind us, you've got the Hazelbergs, you've got the South Point, you've got Breakseas and Green Island, they're all a part of the Ruapuke group. So that's the Ruapuke chain. So yeah, all the landowners here affiliate to these islands. So the bees, yeah.
Which is exciting.
Yeah, that's our new venture. So we did a test run last year of three hives and tried to see what content the honey was going to come out and, you know, if bees could survive here. They have had a hard winter. I lost two hives last year due to just not being able to get here. They didn't get any flight time. So if you recall, it would have been July, August, we had that 6 weeks of just screamed and rain and screamed. So I had two hives starve. I left a heap of honey there, and they were really strong hives, so they would have been peeling through the food. That's come to the big decision why I need to be here full time. But the pollination from the bees is, it's really done its thing, eh? You know, when we get to March, we'll be eating these, which is going to be awesome.
Pears and apples.
Pears and apples, the whole lot. No, Honda's the way to go. Over here.
Right.
So
brute force doesn't cut it.
Brute force does not cut it.
Start your quad
at Ruapuke. Yeah, well,
connect your battery first.
Yeah.
Get the fan going.
Yeah, she's just, it's a piece of shit. Yeah, looks good. But boy hell, what a piece of crap.
Brute force.
Yeah, don't go near it.
Business class on Ruapuke Island.
Oh, it's a nice cushion you're sitting on.
So where are you taking me?
To Tuaiuki's cannon. So that was, he got given two cannons back in the day through trading and all the rest of it. One was situated here at Ruapuke Island, and I'm not quite sure, but I'm pretty sure it's up, the other one's up Jack's Point. But if someone, I'll ask someone else, yeah, actually, yeah. Get the real deal, but we definitely got one here anyway. Yeah, so a couple of the family did some really good work on getting this restored. So as a kid, that was just the cannon on the ground, you know?
Yeah.
Jocto and Ricky, I don't know who else was involved, but, you know, to get it mounted up onto its mount, probably needs another paint to be fair, which we can easily do. But yeah, this is a bit of history. A lot of history, actually, so.
That is a lot of history.
And it's mounted perfectly, you know? It's awesome.
Wow. So where was it originally?
It was off a ship, so I'm led to believe, from England. And, yeah, Tuaiuki, part of his trading, acquired two of them, so.
Wow.
Yeah, it's wicked is what it is. So this is where the old flax mill was.
Yeah, no, she's not operational, is it?
No.
It'd take a bit to restore it too, I think.
Oh, a bit of grace, a bit of Kiwi ingenuity.
Yeah.
We'll be ripping into her. It would have been awesome to see them bring it up, just how they did it. It just blows my mind. The ingenuity and, you know, out those old timers, they must have been bloody hard. That tank wasn't left like that.
Oh, really?
I lost one of those tanks.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't tie it down before I hooked her up.
Now we gotta turn the bike off.
Yep. We don't want to be draining the battery. It just keeps on going.
Beautiful, we're all set.
Trust me, I've learned many a time. Bloody glorious day though, wasn't it? Hey?
Couldn't be better.
John said he wanted tea, so we better go catch some. Because we brought no eggs.
We got bacon, but no eggs.
We got bacon, no eggs.
And Dan's got all the chickens.
Yeah. So what we're after is just a bit of sand and weed, just that edge, you know, we're not after to rape and pillage, we're just going to get a feed, and if we catch too many, I know there's a couple of the whānau coming over, so we'll just give them a feed as well, and everyone's got a koi, nice and fresh, fresh is best. So here's the saying, we don't want to take heaps, we're only going to leave this down for, well, we'll go do our thing a couple of hours, and that's enough. Back in the day when they were tailing crayfish, you know, some of the moki were like, you know, they're massive, you know, because they just fed on crayfish bodies all the time. Monsters, you know, we catch a big moki now and we think, you know, oh, that's really big, but these old boys go, oh, you should have seen them back in the 70s, you know, you're talking, and they're hand feeding them. I was just chilling, checking us out. What are you guys about? Thank you. Some antihistamines here, but if you don't have any side effects, you're all good. Fucking right in the fucking middle of the head. Jesus! What a fuck up that was.
It's a good story though, Dan.
Yeah, it is a good story. Hey, we like cock ups, don't we?
Oh, absolutely.
As long as you're alright, Tay.
Yeah, no. So, what side effects
did I put? No, you would have had them. Just swelling.
Up for a cup of tea.
Can't put the jig on.
Feel those eyes, people. Feel the eyes. Not looking too bad. Holy shit, son. The old bitch has got me good.
Bees.
So being the good man that I am, I'm going to sit behind the camera and watch Dan do all the work.
He's already been smacked in the eyes, so why not?
Yeah.
Got a feed now.
There we go.
Look at that for a thumper. So you know how I was talking about the Moki?
Yeah,
this is a Moki. But in the old boys' styles, that one there's a small one. He's a goodie. Baked fish tonight, eh?
Better than what Boo Boo did.
What did Boo Boo do?
Got about 6 minutes. Mate.
Oh, I did too. Yeah, I seen you, Boo Boo. Oh yeah. This is where I come and chill out. She's the drop. Thank you.
Dan's gone back to cook up the fish, and I'm gonna wait here until I get a little bit nicer light. And I've got a frame, I think that'll work.